So the Lord, in the readings tonight, the prophet Isaiah was the first reading, and the prophet Isaiah is speaking to us about the Messiah, and about the one who would free Israel, the one who would come and be Savior and Lord. And so that's really where we begin. Who is our Savior and Lord? Should be on the tip of your tongue. Jesus. Better be. Otherwise, we'll cancel the Mass and just move on. So, Jesus. And in the Gospel, we hear Jesus actually proclaiming himself to be Messiah and Savior. And he was in his own town of Nazareth. And that scripture was read. And he simply sat down after the scripture was read and said, "This day, this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." And that's really meant for us, but it was meant for them in that day too. That this day, your Savior has come for you. This day, the Lord Jesus is speaking to you. This day, the Lord Jesus is speaking to each and every one of us. And he's calling us in a special way to be his people. And each of you that have these stoles on your shoulders, these symbols of confirmation, if you will, you are, from now on, witnesses of Jesus Christ. And the way you witness to him is by following his two great commandments. And you know what they are. We talked about them. So, two great commandments. I'm the Lord your God, you shall not have any gods before you. So that's part of the Ten Commandments. And the two great commandments, love God with your whole heart and soul and mind and strength. So you're right on. And the second one is like it.
Love your neighbor as
yourself. Those should be on the tip of our tongues, all of us. And it should be who we are, how we live, how we are with our parents, how we are with our brothers and sisters, how we are with our husband and wife, how we are with those with whom we work, those with whom we go to school. It is about God's love. And it's about God's love touching us such that we love ourselves. So when we look in the mirror, and even though it's a bad hair day, we still say, God loves me and I love me. And then you take that love to your parents. And you might try it, young people, in the morning when you go in for breakfast and your mother and father and grandparents are there, guardians are there, tell them, I love you. Then call the ambulance because they're going to be on the floor. They're going to be on the floor. So tell them, I love you. I love you. Because we are signs of Jesus Christ. We are a sign that he came, he died for us, for our sins, and that he has risen from the dead. That's a wow moment. Science can't explain that. But he's risen from the dead for us. So for all of us, death has no more power over us. We are free. Jesus has shown us the way to God. Jesus loves us that much. God loves us that much to send us his son. And then we come to the Acts of the Apostles that was read tonight. And the story is a story that speaks really powerfully of the church, and the church being born, alive, coming to life. And one of the things that was taking place, and so to kind of understand what was taking place, how many have heard an airplane fly over and you've heard the sonic boom happen? How many have heard the sonic boom? So we have a few people that have heard the sonic boom. Well, the scripture says, a loud driving wind. So it was boom! Is everybody awake now? So it was a loud driving wind, and it literally changed their lives. And the tongues of fire, the Spirit, were shown over the top of each of the disciples. And it's over you tonight. The Spirit of God coming upon you. And it changed their lives. So fishermen truly became fishers of men. They became witnesses of Jesus Christ. unto death. And that's who you're called to be, witnesses of Jesus Christ, unto death. And to offer your life to Him, and let Him guide you and lead you and speak to you. And so, the gifts of the Spirit were poured out on the church at that moment. And so the gifts of the Spirit are to be poured out on you tonight. So we talked a little bit about those before Mass. So, the gifts of the Spirit are wisdom, counsel, understanding. I gave you a cheat sheet. Tell me here. Fortitude.
Knowledge.
Piety. And fear of the Lord. Yes. Yes. They're nervous. They're nervous. I don't blame them because the Spirit is about to boom in your lives. Look out. It's coming for you. And so, wisdom of God. Wouldn't it be wonderful to have the wisdom of God that touches your life in such a way that you know who should be your boyfriend or girlfriend? And to have the knowledge of God such that you understand, and the gift of your understanding that touches your life in such a way that you know which college to go to. And wouldn't it be wonderful also to have the counsel of God in your lives? To come through your parents and your grandparents and your teachers and friends, but still, the counsel of God to show you the way God is calling you to be, who God is calling you to be, the vocation God is calling you to. And then to have the courage, fortitude, to be able to speak that witness and that call of God to those around you, no matter what the cost, that you love Jesus Christ. He's the center of your lives, and no one and nothing can separate you from that love, as St. Paul tells us. And then to be a people of piety, of prayer, of the Word of God, who are willing to live out the love of God, loving God with our whole heart and soul and mind and strength, and loving our neighbor as ourselves. I had a chance to celebrate the sacrament of confirmation this past weekend with Cardinal DiNardo in Houston, and we had 300 people we confirmed that night. And he came to this part of his little talk, and he said, you know, in modern terms, speaking about the fear of the Lord, modern terms, it is, we have an awesome God. That's what fear of the Lord really is. We have an awesome God. And a God who loves us without limit. A God who shares His life with us. It's those seven gifts of the Spirit that God gives to you. Now, who's received confirmation out there? Raise your hand. You received confirmation. Okay. So all of you that's received confirmation, which gift of the Holy Spirit are you praying for tonight? Because the gifts didn't stop when you received confirmation. They began then. The seven gifts are being given to these, our young people and our adults. Which gift are you praying for tonight of wisdom and knowledge and understanding and counsel and fear of the Lord and piety, fortitude? What are you praying for? So as we enter this Eucharist, pray for those gifts in your life. Pray for the gifts in your lives. You ready? You sure? Here we go.